Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome into this Adobe After Effects tutorial brought to you by tutvid.com. My name is Nathaniel Dodds, and today we're going to take a look at this pretty cool transition effect, which I can only describe as like a smooth split-screen parallax transition. Check out the example of it so you can see exactly what it looks like and see if you're interested in sticking around and checking out how to make this in Adobe After Effects. And there you go. That's the effect. If you thought it was cool, if you think it's something you like, well, let's jump into After Effects right now and check it out. Alrighty, well, this After Effects tutorial is actually going to kick off here in Adobe Premiere Pro, because what's the sense in creating a transition if I don't at least show you how to apply it to an actual video project you're working on in, let's say, Premiere Pro? So I've got these two clips here, and we got the sunset on the beach, and it kicks to just some young people walking along the beach, and we want the transition to take place here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to just move to the split in the clip, and I'm going to move back 1 second to 13 seconds here. And what I'm going to do is overlap my footage just like that. I'm going to work with a 1 second overlap here. Now what I'm going to do is use my razor tool, and I'm just going to zip the footage right like that. So you can see we now have these two clips that we can select just like that, and we can ship these over to After Effects by right clicking on them. We've got them both selected, by the way. Right click on them and choose replace with After Effects composition. It couldn't be much easier. And After Effects is going to say, hey, where do you want to save this After Effects project file? I'm going to throw it on my desktop for now, and I'm just going to call it rect AE for recorded After Effects. And you can see here what we've got. I'm going to just set this to fit on my screen. We have our two little layers here, and everything here has been brought into Adobe After Effects. Now, a couple just important things to note here. As we create this effect, we are, if I come up here to composition settings, we're creating this effect here at 2560 by 1440. So if we wanted to use this on video that was 1080p, well, if I go back to Premiere Pro here and check out my sequence settings, I need to actually select that sequence there. I can go sequence settings. I can see that this is a 2560 by 1440 sequence. So if you're working at 1080p, 1920 by 1080, you want to make sure that you're sending footage from that size file over. The reason I mention it now is because this elaborate animation effect we're going to create, it's going to work for footage that is 2560 by 1440. You would need to create a new effect for something that's 1920 by 1080. But once you do it for that size, we'll be able to swap the footage in and out and use this transition for all kinds of different effects, or really projects, I should say. So I have all these files here in my project bin. The first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to create a new folder and just say from Prem, and it's just, you know, from Premiere Pro, basically. I'm going to leave this comp here, but I'm going to select all four of these files. I'm going to drag them into that from Prem folder just to keep things tidied up a little bit. In fact, I can select this comp, I can right click and rename it, and I'm going to call this transition split screen or something like that. Then what I'm going to do is down here, I'm going to pre-comp my two bits of video. So young people on the beach, this is going to be the video that is going to be replaceable. I'm going to right-click on it and choose Precompose, and I'm going to name this pre-comp. I'm going to name it footage underscore replace. That way, when I want to come in and replace this footage and have a different footage swap in but retain the transition effect, I can right-click on this footage and click nothing here. Actually, what I would do is I would double-click into that composition, and then here I have this video, and you would just drag your new video into the composition. Had a little bit of a brain fart there for a second. I'm going to close that pre-comp, and I'm going to pre-comp the sunset beach footage as well. Right-click, pre-compose, and I'm going to name this footage underscore background. And once more, if we wanted to replace the background, the footage from which we're moving, we would simply replace the footage in this background composition. All right, so the first thing I want to do is create a series of shapes moving across my frame. And the way I'm going to do this and ensure that they are the proper size and proportionate, I'm going to go view, and I want to make sure that I show my grid, and then I'm also going to make sure snap to grid is turned on. So there's view show grid, and then I'm going to say, yeah, snap to the grid as well. Now this is a 1440 wide document. And basically, I want to have 40 grid squares going across my document. I don't really care where they are in terms of the height. I just want to make sure that the width, that there are 40 squares going across the document. So in this case, I would say, all right, this is a 2560 wide frame. I would go 2560 divided by 40, and that equals 64. So I know that each of these grid squares, these cells, need to be 64 pixels across. So I can go here to After Effects Preferences, and I can come down here to Grids and Guide. This would be under the Edit Preferences menu if you're not on the Mac, by the way. And you can see here, for my grid, I have a grid line every 64 pixels. So that's perfect. It's going to work great for me. It's exactly what I want. If you're working with your standard 1080p, 1920 by 1080, so it's 1920 wide, 1920 divided by 40 is 48. So you go a grid line every 48 pixels in that case. So I'm going to say okay here. We can shut off these background video tracks if they're distracting and just work here, because we're just going to create a series of shapes. I might back this out a little bit more. Let's go to like 50%, something like that. And I think what I want to do is create 8 rectangles across my entire document. Now, I don't need these to be exactly perfect. I'm just going to begin at one side, and I know that all 8 of them need to be 5 cells across. 8 times 5 is 40, and we know we have 40 little cells running across this. So I'm first going to make sure that I don't have any layers down here selected, because if I grab my shape tool and I start creating a shape and I have a layer selected, it's going to create a mask. All right, so we've got snapping turned on, so I can just go ahead and say, all right, 5 wide, and there we go, about that tall. That's great. Now I want to deselect so I don't create a second shape or mask within that shape layer. And I'm going to go ahead and draw out another shape. Make sure that we're 5 cells wide. Great. So I've got 2 shapes. And I'm going to have 3 shapes here in just a moment. I'm going to be very cognizant to deselect every time I go back to the well for another shape. And I can just collapse all these layers as well just to keep things kind of tidy. I'm going to go and drag another shape out. There we go. 5 cells across. And shape number 6. Voila. 5 cells across. Let me collapse more shape layers in my layers panel. I make sure I'm not selecting anything. Let's go 5 more cells across. Voila. Deselect that. And then last but not least, our last little rectangle. 5 cells across. So you can see here we have 8 shape layers in our layers area. They're all 5 cells across, and they all have an anchor point exactly in the center of our frame, regardless of where the shape is. You can see this shape over here on the left, anchor point right there in the middle. This shape over here on the right, bam, anchor point still in the exact same spot in the middle. That's great. And by the way, as you're creating your shapes, you can use the hotkey, and I should have mentioned this, Command-Shift-D, that'd be Control-Shift-D on the PC to quickly deselect whatever you have selected. That way you can drag out a shape, Command-Shift-D, drag out another shape, Command-Shift-D, and so on and so forth. So now what we're going to do is we're going to create the animation, and then we're going to worry about masking it and creating our transition. So we're going to work with the 2 outermost shapes first. So that's Shape Layer 8 and Shape Layer 1. I'm going to hold down my Command or Control key, and I'm going to select both 8 and 1, and then I'm going to hit the letter P, which is going to open the positioning options for those 2 shape layers. Now what I like to do is move out to about 15 frames right there. You can see 15 frames. Voila. And I'm going to drop a keyframe by just hitting this little stopwatch, which is going to toggle animation. Now, because I've got both layers selected, it's going to drop that keyframe for both layers. Very easy, very nice. And then I'm going to move back to frame 1. And basically, I just want to change the Y positioning, the 720 number here. I want to just scroll that back so these white shapes are up above the frame. So I'm just going to pull that back. I'm going to pull it back even further. I think I got to get to like negative 720 or so. Maybe I'm going to square it off at negative 760. And we'll just make a mental note of that. We're at negative 760. And now if I play through this video, boom, we just have these white shapes over the course of 15 frames, half a second in our case, because our composition settings are, you can see, about 30 frames per second, 29.97. It's basically 30 frames per second, so it's going to be a half second. Bam, those white shapes drop down. Now, I do want to hold down Shift and just make sure I select all 4 of these keyframes. And then I'm just going to simply hit F9. That's going to apply an easy ease to this, which just makes the animation a little smoother, gives it a little bounce and snap into place, makes it look a little bit more professional and just nice. Now what we're going to do is we're going to repeat this process for layers 2 and 7, layers 3 and 6, and layers 4 and 9. So I'm going to select these 2 layers, I'm going to hit the letter P. In this case, I'm going to move out maybe to like frame 17. No, let's go frame 19. I'm sorry. I want to go like 4 frames past 15. We're going to drop a keyframe here, and then I'm going to come back to frame 4. This is where this animation will begin, and we're going to set this to, what was it, negative 760, right? And because we have both layers selected, you can see that both shapes are up. Let's hold down Shift and select all these keyframes, and we're simply going to hit F9, and boom, our next animation is done. So now if we play this, you can see we get everything coming together. Boom, we get this sort of double drop effect. That's pretty cool. And maybe what we'll try to do, we'll try to keep some of this offset, but in order to really make things interesting, maybe what we'll do is take the frames here at the end and really push them close together. So maybe they'll end up just one frame apart in terms of how and where they finish. That'll vary the speed and just everything about the transition a little bit more. I think that'll be a neat little effect to have. All right, I'm going to take layers 3 and 6, hit the letter P to open up positioning. I'm going to jump out here just one frame beyond at frame 17. We're going to drop our keyframe to activate animation. And maybe here we'll just move two frames out. We're just going to really mix things up here. And just, we kind of want this to look structured yet kind of organic at the same time. I'm going to make sure I hold down shift, select all my keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease this, and let's check to see what we've got. Boom. So you can see we're getting this really neat looking effect where it's like everything is just kind of wablam, slamming down into place. And last but not least, layers 4 and 5, hit the letter P, and let's jump out here. Let's go out just one frame beyond. We're going to activate animation for this. And this one, we'll just start one frame after right here. And we're going to set this to negative 760 as we have been the entire time. Hold down shift to make sure we select all of those keyframes. And then hit F9 for an easy ease. And now if I take a look at this, we get this really cool looking animation of these boxes just kind of falling out of the sky, and it looks pretty natural. Now we can introduce additional organicness or more of a natural feel by adjusting where our keyframes start and stop. So I can like drag this one back a little bit. Maybe I'll drag this back one, drag this back one. The two center, I want those to stay together at all times. So I think I'm going to be okay with that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to move these back just a little bit. So I think something like that. Let's see what this looks like. Just really going to mix things up and make it, give it a little bit more of like a wave effect. So just mixing up the keyframes a little bit like that just adds like an element of randomness to this. All right, I'm going to select all my shape layers here. I'm going to hit the little fly out arrow there and just collapse everything, tidy up our layers panel. We're going to start opening stuff up in just a second again, but I just want to make it look nice for the moment. So we can turn on our footage background now. I'm actually going to get rid of footage replace because I'm going to get rid of it just for the sake of what we're about to do here. But what I want to do is I want to drag out a copy of footage replace for each of these shape layers, and we're going to mask it to that shape layer. So check this out. We're going to go footage replace, drag one down here beneath shape layer one, and I know you're thinking, you just deleted it. Why are you dragging out a new one? It's honestly just to walk you through the entire process, soup to nuts. And then we have this toggle switches button down here. Maybe this is what your layers panel looks like. You want to hit this little toggle switches button because we want to get this track mat option. And here for footage replace, the one we just dragged out, we want to set the alpha mat to be shape layer 1. So that's this animated layer right above it. Bam. And now what's going to happen is as that first shape animates in, it's going to just animate one strip of the video dropping down like that. Very, very cool. But we're not finished yet. I'm going to speed up the footage here, and I'm just going to quickly mask all of the remaining footage replaces here to all of these other clips as you're seeing me do here in the sped up video. And I'll be back in just a second, and I want to show you one last really cool thing that we're going to do to really help complete this effect. Alrighty, so if I just quickly scroll through this, we can see that we have our video now transitioning from that beach shot to just this shot of the people walking down the beach. How can we make this cooler? How can we make it even better? Well, let me show you here. I'm going to make my timeline a little bit larger, number one, so we can really see what's going on. Check this out. I am going to toggle down my initial footage replace here. In fact, I'm going to select it, and I'm going to hit the letter P to bring up my positioning again. I'm also going to toggle down the shape layer here. Now, our shape layer, remember, we animated the position of the shape layer. You can see we got the blue stopwatch. It means, yep, that's been turned on. Animating's been turned on. If I look out here in the timeline, sure enough, two keyframes. Great. Check this out. With position here, I'm going to hold down Alt or Option and click on the stopwatch for this position. And what it's going to do is open up my expression option. I don't really need to write any expressions though. I'm just going to use this little twirly gig doodad. It's called the pick whip. And I'm going to drag it and drop it on the word position, not on the numbers out here, but rather on the word position. And what's going to happen is this footage replace layer is now going to animate along the Y axis. As this shape mask slides down, it will look like a slice of video is sliding down as well. So see how the rest of this video is just simply being uncovered? Well, now this slice of video over here on the far left, it's actually sliding down with the mask. So that's going to help our video to have a very disjointed effect, but then right at the end, as all these pieces drop into place, all the video will come together perfectly. So it's going to be a really, really cool effect. So once more, here, I'm going to open up footage replace. I'll select it, hit the letter P to bring up position, open up my shape layer, and there I've got my positioning right there. I'm going to hold down Alt or Option and click on the stopwatch, grab the pick whip, and link it to the position, and then I'll just collapse those two layers. Now I'm simply going to speed up the video here, and I'm going to go ahead and knock out the rest of this stuff, and just pick whip up the rest of these layers so we can really see what the completed effect kind of looks like before we send it back over to Premiere. All right, there we go. I've got everything linked up. You can see here, if I open up footage replace, our positioning, it's linked now. It is starting at -760, and it's just basically saying, look, it's going to follow along with shape layer 8 in terms of the position of the transform. We're not going to get into how all the expressions work in this video, but basically now you're going to see, as this begins, we have our video looking like it's all sliced up. Like, say how his arm is all disjointed, and her legs are here, and her legs are down there. But then as the whole video comes to a conclusion, everything just kind of, bam, drops right into place, clicks right into place, looks great. I'm going to shut off the grid because that's just kind of annoying and in the way right now. But you can see how we have a really cool little effect of our video. Just boom, there you go. There's the transition, just like that. All we have to do is save the document, which I just did, and I'm going to return to Premiere Pro, and we can see that we've got this pink linked comp thing here, and that's just from After Effects. And if I play through this now, you can see, by the way, it's red, it's not rendered, but we're going to give it a shot and see how it looks. We can see that there's our transition. Boom. Seamless. Right there now in Adobe Premiere Pro. We just created that transition. Now, what if we wanted to change this transition and use it in a different video project? Well, number one, we would go to After Effects and we would save it as, and then I would save it as, you know, some other transition or something, and I would save it. And then this could be my file that I go and I copy a bunch of times and I use it in this project and that project and the other project, right? That's up to you, however you want to handle your file management. But let me show you how easy it is to swap out the footage, because you might be looking at this and saying, eight video files I need to swap out. This is crazy. Well, no, this is why we just made this simple pre-comp where I can go in and drop the footage out and add new footage and be done with it. Because all we have to do here is, well, I'm going to jump out to my Finder. I've got two space shuttle shots here. I'm going to drag these and drop them into my project. I'm going to double click on, well, let's start with footage background. And I'm going to say, look, shuttle shot one. Yeah, we're going to bring you out to here. And I'll drop that on the timeline. We can see it's only, whatever, 6.5 seconds, not quite 7. That's fine. We can delete Sunset Beach from this pre-comp. And now, of course, this shuttle image, this is only 1080p, but no worries. We can go layer, we can choose transform and choose fit to comp. It's going to just scale it up and make sure it works for us and looks good and everything like that. That's cool. I can close this comp. Let's delete our footage background here, and we'll just drag out a new copy of footage background. And you can see we've got our space shuttle right there. Let's close up footage background. Let's open up footage replace now. And all we need to do is replace our MOV here. So I'm going to drag out the second space shuttle shot. I'm going to go layer, transform, scale, or fit to comp, I should say. There we go. I'm going to delete the young people on the beach shot. I'll save my file. I'm going to close this. And now back here, we're not going to have to change all these pre-comps out like I deleted just to kind of refresh the background. You can see here, if I play through, we automatically now have that new footage just being dropped right into place. So really, really cool. And it's quite a simple thing. Now, obviously, the more your footage is kind of timed and sized correctly, the easier all of this is going to be. But that's all stuff that you're just going to work out on your own, how you manage your files and things like that. The point is, you can create an effect here in After Effects, save it out as a separate file, and very, very quickly swap the footage in something like a pre-comp and have a rather complex transition like this. I mean, this is a mildly complex, I would say, where you have all these different layers of video that are moving at once, and just by replacing one file, you go ahead and replace all these instances of the video here across this transition in Adobe After Effects. So there you have it. It's a little bit of a process, but the nice thing is, of course, once you've done it once, you can just swap that footage in or out and apply this effect to all sorts of different clips and all sorts of different projects, and you've got a nice little transition that you created yourself. If you enjoyed this video, guys, make sure you go ahead and subscribe to my channel so you never miss any video editing tutorials, past, present, or future. If you're into Discord, you can check us out over at discord.me/tutvid, where the conversation goes on and on and on. And also, if you're into Instagram, or you have Instagram, you can follow me over on Instagram, @tutvid. Guys, for messing around with some pre-composition, some layer masks, and some motion tweening, and easing, and just all the little things that we did to build out this effect here in Adobe After Effects right now in this video, that's it. Get it? Got it? Good. Nathaniel Dodson, tutvid.com. I'll catch you in the next one. And before you go, make sure you subscribe to my channel for more great tutorials every day. Also, buy my course. It helps us do what we do, and this channel is supported by viewers just like you. You can also just click the thumbnail and watch another video from this channel. See you next time, guys.